Hey, what's going on, guys? Today I'm going to talk about something that I know many others have said before, and that is that I feel Destiny 2 should have been an expansion or DLC to Destiny 1. Now, before any of you who love Destiny 2 start typing all those lovely comments about how I should delete my channel because I have a differing viewpoint than you, let me remind you that this is merely my opinion, but it also seems like 90% or more of players seem to agree with me on several key points. So if you love Destiny 2 and think the game is amazing, more power to you. But please hear me out and think about what I'm about to say, as you may find yourself agreeing with me on this. And for all of you that love Destiny 1 and hate Destiny 2, well, I hope I do a good job of voicing why many of us think Destiny 2 would be better as an expansion. Let me first start off by saying that I think the biggest issue here is that Destiny 2 feels like a very disconnected sequel, because Bungie is trying to replicate the Halo formula where they have three big main games and maybe a spin-off. The problem is, though, that when applying that formula to Destiny, it just doesn't work. And Halo having three separate games worked out well, and sequels fit naturally, because each game had its own campaign and multiplayer, and the DLCs were often just multiplayer maps. So for Halo, making a new game every 3 years is an okay move, because you're not customizing Master Chief, you're not taking him on a journey across the galaxy to different hub worlds, and you're not helping him earn an exotic battle rifle. Halo is a linear first-person story-driven experience, while Destiny is supposed to be a personal journey and adventure. When Bungie set out to make Destiny, the phrase that was tossed around constantly was that Destiny was going to be a 10-year experience. Well, now with how Destiny 2 has launched, that 10-year experience seems like it is going to be three separate 3-year experiences. And that seems like the worst way to go about this. When people spend thousands of hours into a game like Destiny, getting the max light level, acquiring the best loot in the game, and customizing the Guardian to the exact caliber they want, why on earth does Bungie think the fans of the experience are going to appreciate a complete reset in Destiny 2? Where not only is all the previous content gone, and the story seems to be disjointed, but the biggest issue for many is that Bungie tried to fix things that didn't need to be fixed. People can blame Activision as much as they want for Eververse, or other problems during development, but it was Bungie that decided to change the game's core foundations, and make the game feel less like a long-term product, and more like an appointment-style game, where you only need to play on Tuesdays. In Destiny 1, the game may have suffered a rough launch, but Bungie spent 3 years ironing out the game into something special that many people loved and enjoyed. If you go back and play Destiny 1 now with all its content, it's an amazing experience. The sheer amount of content and the quality of that content is insane. There is so much to see and do in the game that it will take you hundreds, if not thousands of hours to see and do it all. Now for someone like me who bought the complete edition for $60, it's a phenomenal purchase. But for those who paid upwards of $170 for the entire package, it's a rather pricey game. That's why I think, though, that making Destiny 2 an expansion would work so well. If someone already spent that much money in the game, let them keep investing into that experience, and then the casuals, or those who don't want to pay that much, can just hop into the game whenever there's a complete edition, or a version that has the base game and all DLC up to that point. Then the loyal fans, while maybe paying more, are playing the game as soon as the DLC launches, and getting far ahead on the grind for loot, and the casuals will have to play catch-up, but they are getting the game for a cheaper price. This seemed to work wonders in Destiny 1, with how Bungie handled the Taken King edition on disc, as well as the complete edition, so why not have a Destiny the Red War edition that includes all of Destiny 1's content along with Destiny 2's new content? Now many people will mention the difference in content between the Taken King and Destiny 2. So let's take a moment to look into each one's content, not including exclusives that the PlayStation has. The Taken King had 8 main story missions, totaling about 3-5 hours of gameplay, a small handful of side story missions, and the Taken War questline, which was essentially more side activities. 1 raid, 3 strikes, 7 new PvP maps, and 1 new patrol zone. Destiny 2 has 17 main story missions, totaling 6-7 hours of gameplay, a large amount of side activities such as Lost Sectors and Adventures, 1 raid, 5 strikes, 10 PvP maps, and 4 new patrol zones. Okay, so in looking to the differences here, Destiny 2 has a larger amount of content and is a better looking game than The Taken King. But I would argue that Destiny 1 still looks phenomenal right now, and a small sacrifice in visuals is more than worth it for a massive gain in content. Some also might argue that since The Taken King was $40, Destiny 2 is easily worth $60, and okay, that's fine with me. Bungie could have made this game a $60 expansion onto Destiny 1 for those players who already have everything, or maybe even offer it for $50 if the player or fan has been constantly buying Destiny content, kind of like a Destiny player rewards card. Then for the new players that Bungie want to grab, by making this seem like a fresh start and a good place to jump into the experience, they could take some risk here and make the game $80 or $100, but it would include all of Destiny 1's content, everything, along with all of Destiny 2's content. I'm not saying I'm guaranteed this would have worked, but to me this seems like a perfectly reasonable solution, from both the commercial point of view as well as the consumer point of view. If Destiny 2 was a massive expansion, Bungie would not have faced issues with the gameplay changes, they would have kept their loyal fans, and they would have created a damn good long-term experience that could continue to be built upon for the next 6 years. Okay, well that's just my opinion and idea on how Bungie could have better handled Destiny 2, but I want to know your thoughts and opinions as well. Do you think this would be an acceptable idea, or do you prefer the separate Destiny experiences? Let me know in the comments below, and as always, if you like this video and you want to see more like it, be sure to leave a like and hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you all on the next Shepherd Gaming video. Keyless Ally.